Today we will see shape function and its properties. See, in finite element analysis, the variation of displacement within an element is expressed by its nodal displacements and with the help of interpolation functions. Means the displacement at any point within an element can be expressed with the help of nodal displacement and by using the interpolation function. Suppose if u is the displacement at any point in the element, then we can write u is equal to summation ni qi, where qi is the nodal displacement and ni is the interpolation function or shape function. So here the displacement at any point within an element can be expressed with the help of this nodal displacement and the shape function, or it is also called as interpolation function. So displacement at any point within an element u is equal to summation ni qi. By using this you can find out the displacement at any point along the length of the element. In simple words, you can say that the shape function is nothing but the interpolation function considered in natural coordinate system. Now for example, I will consider a 1D bar element. This is node number 1, node number 2. We will consider this 1D bar element in natural coordinate system, which is defined by zeta, or which is represented by zeta. Here at node 1, I will consider the nodal displacement as q1. At node number 2, I will consider the nodal displacement as q2. I will take u as the displacement at any point along the length of this element. Now, I told you the displacement at any point along the length of this element can be expressed with the help of this nodal displacement and the shape function. So, displacement at any point along the length of the element u is given by n1 q1 plus n2 q2. Here, where n1 and n2 are the shape functions. And q1 and q2 are nodal displacement. I told you n1 and n2 are the shape functions, which is nothing but the interpolation function considered in natural coordinate system. Therefore, you can write n1 is equal to a0 plus a1 zeta. Here in place of x we will get zeta, because we are considering this in natural coordinate system, and n2 is a2 plus a3 zeta. Next, the properties of shape function. First one, the number of shape functions is equal to the number of nodes present in the element, provided the degree of freedom of the nodes are purely translation. Means if the degrees of freedom at the nodes are purely translation, then the number of shape functions will be equal to the number of nodes present in the element. If you take the example of this 1D bar element, here we have two nodes and each node has got only 1 degrees of freedom. Node 1 got Q1 and node 2 got Q2. Both are translation. In such cases, when the number of shape functions will be equal to number of nodes present in the element. Here there are two nodes, degree of freedom of each node is translation. Therefore, the number of shape functions will be equal to number of nodes present in the element. So, the number of shape functions is equal to the number of nodes present in the element provided the degree of freedom of the nodes are purely translation. This is the first property of the shape function. Next, second one. Shape functions are defined in natural coordinates and it is denoted by N. This is the second property. Shape functions are defined in natural coordinates and it is denoted by N, capital letter N. Next third property, the shape function will have value equal to 1 at their corresponding nodes and they are 0 at all other nodes. So if you take the example of this 1D bar element, I told you there will be two shape functions N1 and N2. See, the third property says that the shape function will have value equal to 1 at their corresponding nodes. Means, see, this N1 corresponds to node 1. So the value of shape function N1 will be equal to 1 at node number 1 and the value of N1 will be equal to 0 at node number 2. Similarly, this shape function N2 corresponds to node number 2. Therefore, the value of shape function N2 will be equal to 1 at corresponding node, means at node number 2, because N2 corresponds to node number 2. If we consider N2 in node number 1, then the value of N2 will be equal to 0. So the third property says that the shape function will have value equal to 1 at their corresponding nodes and they are 0 at all other nodes. So third property, the shape function will have value equal to 1 at their corresponding nodes and they are 0 at all other nodes. This is the third property. Fourth property, sum of the shape functions is always equal to 1. Again, if you take the same example, here there are two shape functions n1 and n2. The fourth property says that the sum of the shape functions is always equal to 1, means n1 plus n2 will be equal to 1. Fourth property, sum of the shape functions is always equal to 1, that is summation ni is equal to 1. These are the properties of shape function. The first property is the number of shape functions is equal to the number of nodes present in the element, provided the DOF of the nodes are purely translation. Second one is the shape functions are defined in natural coordinates and it is denoted by n. The third property, the shape function will have value equal to 1 at their corresponding nodes and they are 0 at all other nodes. The fourth property is sum of the shape functions is always equal to 1, that is summation ni is equal to 1. See, we have to remember all the four properties because these properties are required in order to derive the shape functions. Thank you.